Scars. Just tell me, for those that don't know, what's Battle Scars about, lawyer?
Battle Scars is a Lewis's tournament, basically. It's based on the ideals of Kung Fu, but in a lyrical form. So it's like the lyrical version of Bruce Lee's Enter the Dragon. Rappers, poets, chatters, whatever you do as a lyricist, yeah, it's about bringing your style, your technique to the stage and competing against other lyricists. So it's not about cussing your opponent, it's about having been a master of your art form. So if you're a singer, I mean, you like, basically sing your battles, I mean, like, so the rules are there's no family cussing, there's no racism and no physical contact. What we're trying to do is basically bring the different elements of skills. So the first round is a showcase round where you bring your own backing track and you perform for 1 minute your best verse or the best thing that you've done, basically, to astound the crowd. And 12 people were chosen to go through to the battling rounds. The first round of the battling round is 1 minute, one chance against your opponent. A beat is given by a DJ. You can say to him, speed it up, slow it down, or you can go a cappella. And you do your thing against your opponent. Yeah, it's best to keep it in the context of, you know what I mean, there's somebody in front of you, you're saying that you're better than them or whatever. You're basically lyrically outshining your opponent. Yeah, some people choose to cuss, some people don't, you know what I mean, but that's the idea, you're lyrically outshining your opponent. When you get eliminated from there, you go to the next round. The next round is the round with a bang. This time here, you've got two chances, so you get a chance to counter attack and come back again. Yeah, you've got 30 seconds to make your beat with a band and a minute to spit or do whatever you do. So basically, you go up and you say to the drummer, give me that boom, kick, boom, boom, kick. Drummer starts giving you that bass line. So you put your vibe to the thing and then you've got a minute to lyrically slaughter or whatever to annihilate your opponent. Not necessarily cussing him, but just to bust wicked patterns, flows, verses, whatever you're doing, yeah? Round after that, this is where you need either a barrage of lyrics or some freestyle skill. You've got 5 minutes, there's three people left. You've got 5 minutes, yeah, and the band jams, basically, and you've got 8 bars each, yeah, for about 5 minutes. Then the weakest one gets knocked out, and the last two go 8 bars to the death. Either you run out of lyrics, or your lyrics are rubbish, and the rain of towels are coming, and you're finished, or we run out of time, and we have to judge. But basically, that's the fight to the death. 8 bars continuous, yeah? And then we have our winner. They take £200, they get all the fame and glory, and basically they definitely get a place in the grand final where they can battle for a grand and the championship title. So that's what Battle Scars is all about.
What gave you the idea in the first place? How did it all start about?
Basically, I used to be an MC myself, like I want to be a rapper. Then I had to like make the music myself and stuff like that. For making the music, like there was no outlets, you couldn't get a record deal. So basically, I put my own label together. From that, putting my own label together, the next problem was getting the promotion and distribution. So to get the promotion, started putting on a talent show called Vibes, and me and Michael used to host it. And then basically from that, sorted out a little distribution deal and blah, blah, blah. The next release I did was with somebody else's track, a crew called Pro Cryptics, which was Sparky and Nava. And basically from that, their first EP was called The Inky Fist Assassin, and had a track on it called Battle Scars. And so I was like working out, just thinking, so how can I make these guys famous and promote it? And I thought, you know what, because there was Kung Fu samples in the track as well. So it sort of like my mind works different. It goes away and comes back with the ideas and stuff like that. So it goes, yo, put on an MC battle, call it Battle Scars, and make that man host it. And then it was the idea of putting that was basically the idea. And then it was about putting a format, and because it's Kung Fu, it's about, you know, like Kung Fu is about different disciplines. It's a very disciplined, it's martial arts basically. So it's not just about you just getting there and just whop off your opponent's head and blah, blah. I mean, it's very disciplined. It's about having different skills. And so it was about putting that sort of format, because hip hop was getting through a change. Like you had Mace coming out, and where hip hop and rap was about skill, style and pattern being original, you started to get a load of carbon copies and stuff like that. And the whole music industry is now, it's about being good looking and looking this way. It's not about talent, you know what I mean? So what I wanted to do was bring back that raw talent, the thing of like, when I used to rap, man, with me and my crew used to sit there and write lyrics, be like, right, you want to, and then that, so it was a competition of who could write the wickedest lyrics, different patterns, flows, and put their words, wordplay and stuff like that. And all that was just getting out the window with this real poppy, commercial, watered down rubbish. And I mean, even with all different genres. So it's a case of, you know what, let them do their thing. But man, I want to bring back real, where you see someone and you're just like, wow, that is amazing. Because from getting to talent shows and see, I see some of the ugliest people that are so talented that they're better than some of the biggest artists out there. But they will never get anywhere in the industry as it is because they don't look good. And it's not right. So I was just like, man, I mean, basically do this thing here and showcase wonderful talent and as well bring back that need, because like you've got other MC battles where it's just a cussing match, people actually just talking and just saying the most derogatory thing, and there's no, they ain't got no flow, no style, no pattern, no lyrical skill, no stage presence. You need as an artist, all they can do